My name is Allison Wolf. I'm the executive director of the UC Health Milk Bank. My passion is in helping families and helping babies to nourish our community. I love working with the people here at the Milk Bank. Everybody has that same passion to help feed and nourish our infants. We know that mother's milk is medicine. And we know that, especially for our ill and vulnerable infants, it's even more important that they're able to receive breast milk. And mother's milk is the best for them, but when that's not available because of maybe the mom's sick or there's other maternal factors that she doesn't have enough supply or isn't able to supply breast milk for her baby, we like to be able to fill those gaps with donor milk to help prevent some significant health outcomes. Hundreds of them a year develop what's called necrotizing enterocolitis, or NEC, which is a devastating bowel disease. And we don't know everything that goes into what causes it, but we do know that exposure to formula can increase the risk of NEC. So the priority milk goes to our NICUs and any ill or vulnerable baby that needs it. A lot of hospitals in California are now offering donor milk in their couplet care or mother-baby units. So maybe mama had a C-section or there was another complication and the baby either has excessive weight loss or low blood sugar or needs a little bit extra, and they're able to give the donor milk to these babies kind of as like a bridge until mama's milk comes in. And then we also provide donor milk for medically fragile babies in the community. So maybe it's a baby with a cardiac defect. Again, mom doesn't have enough milk and that she needs to be able to bridge her milk with donor milk because to decrease that formula exposure. So the milk goes to them. And then when there's enough left over, people are able to purchase milk. So maybe it was somebody who had a mastectomy or a surrogate family or whatever reason that mother doesn't have enough milk, she wants to be able to bridge her milk with a donor milk. They're able to come and purchase the milk here from us. The Milk Bank is actually located inside the San Diego Blood Bank, and we did that for a couple different reasons. So milk banking, we fall under what's called a HABANA, which is the Human Milk Banking Association of North America, and there are only around 30 milk banks in all of North America, and so it's not a big group of milk banks, and so a lot of our knowledge we actually get from the blood banking community. And so we thought by partnering with the San Diego Blood Bank, we'd not only be able to build these relationships, gain this knowledge, but we also use some of their infrastructure. So for example, they have couriers that go to the different hospitals in San Diego every day to deliver blood. They also help us deliver milk to the same hospitals. We have a portal that people can go on and log into if they're interested in donation. And we have FAQs, how to donate, all these other things. And if they're interested, they create a login and then they have to answer some questionnaires, sign some consents, and then we do about a 15-minute phone interview with them to kind of go over risks, social factors, any medications, health history, all those things that may impact the safety of their milk. And if all of those look good, we get a consent from their OB or prenatal provider. And once we have that information, we go through with either the executive director or the medical director. We look through all the information and say, yes, social factors, health factors, any risk factors, medications, yes, they're safe to donate. So then that's when they do the next step to actually come here to the blood bank and the milk bank to drop off their milk and get their blood draw. They come out, we meet them, we'll come out with coolers, they unload all their milk, you know, we greet them, tell them about what we're doing, kind of introduce them to the blood bank and the milk bank, and then we walk them back through to the blood bank section where they'll get their blood drawn. The blood test is that one important safety step. It's actually the same test that they do for blood donation. So looking for different communicable diseases that could possibly be in the breast milk that could pass to a baby. And so just like before somebody's able to donate blood, they get these same blood tests done to make sure that that blood or that milk is safe for donation. What we do is we take their milk and we actually put it into a quarantine freezer until we get those blood results back. And then once those results come back, it's actually a two-person approval process. So we sit down and we look through again all of those things again, medications, health history, social risk factors, and all those blood results. Double check it with everything, and at that point, if everything looks good, we approve them. And so once that milk is approved, we're actually able to log it into our milk banking system and put it into the freezers that at some point will be able to be processed. Mm-hmm. let's say they're going to pasteurize and we're doing going to do 100 ml bottles of protein targets. So a couple days prior, one of our milk techs, who's very familiar with every single mom, her calorie count, her protein count, everything, because we've analyzed all the individual moms, and he'll pull the different bags of what we're going to process a couple days later. You'll see the little pumped samples of milk. Those are thawed for a brief period of time. Each individual donor is placed into a separate pot, and a pre-culture sample is sent to laboratory to analyze. We're looking for any sort of, it's a bacillus screen. Bacillus is a bacteria that if it's exposed to heat actually blooms and grows, so we don't want to expose a batch to that. That's then, again, slowly thawed over 48 hours, and when they're ready to process, they pull out these individual pots of the moms. It's usually 5 to 7 donors. We do pool milk, and that's to get a specific calorie count and protein count, and also to ensure that there is what we call a human milk oligosaccharide, an HMO, which is protective against necrotizing enterocolitis. We want to make sure that there's an adequate level of HMOs in each batch so that we're protecting these vulnerable NICU babies. And then it's turned, you'll see the mixers in the lab, and that's to make sure we mix all the fat and everything in, and then a sample is taken and analyzed, so we'll know exactly how many calories and protein are in that big pot of milk. And then the months they figure that out, they're like, okay, great, it's protein target. They're going to dispense it into individual bottles. Those bottles will be capped and then put in the heat pasteurizer. Once that's done, a bottle is taken out and another culture is sent. Those bottles will be put into our blast chiller to quickly cool down and then put into our quarantine freezer until those final culture results are received. One thing I've learned since I've been here is our donors are amazing people, and they do this because they want to help. They want to help others. They want to help families that don't have breast milk for their baby. They want to help other babies. They want to nourish them. And so we see donors from all walks of life. And so we see younger, we see older, we see, you know, IVF, surrogacy. We see a lot of nurses and physicians and OTs and physical therapists because I think they understand the power of breast milk and how that really is medicine. There is a fair group of our donors who actually were able to receive donor milk in the hospital. So maybe their baby was in the NICU, or maybe their baby was in couplet care up at UCSD, and they needed this couple days of bridge milk and they were able to receive it. So a lot of our donors are like, you know what? It meant so much to us to be able to have that gift, that we're going to pay it forward, that I want to be able to do this.